A few generations ago, we had this challenge. It sounds familiar to us today. How do you take an old technology, the printed word, and use a new technology to distribute it in a whole new way so that people, especially kids, have access to literature and information that they just didn't have before? Well, today, I know we've got computers and we have the internet, and that's great. And yet, for all that is, if you love books, you still gotta love the bookmobile.
Well, I'm so tired of crying, but I'm out on the road again. I'm on the road again.
Since 1947, the intrepid crews of the bookmobiles have crisscrossed the highways and byways of St. Louis County, bringing the printed word to where it is most needed. When the county library system was started after World War II, there wasn't enough money to build branches, so they built bookmobiles to bring the books to the readers. In the early years, as many as 26 bookmobiles served mostly rural St. Louis County. Today, 10 units, that's still the largest fleet in the country, serve 125 schools and 100 senior centers. To youngsters, bookmobiles bring that first thrill of discovering how books can be doors into other worlds and new adventures. For lots of grown-ups, bookmobiles can bring back some wonderful memories.
When I was working on Bookmobile 20 as a library assistant, a parent came in and they gave me this sound like, oh, it smells so good. And they wondered whether this bookmobile was the same bookmobile that they had gone to as a child. And I told them, I said, you know, there's a very good possibility that it is, because these bookmobiles have been around here for a very long time.
The library actually constructed the bookmobiles in their own shop. The oldest, still in use, dates back to 1957. They have names like the Tom Sawyer and the Laura Ingalls Wilder, and each can carry as many as 5,000 books.
It's a nice, warm, inviting place to learn about libraries. It's we try to focus on books that we know that they'll like. They still like dinosaurs, they still like bears, they still like joke books, and they still like drawing books, and we never have enough of those. But if a teacher wants to have 25 books on bats, we can get them 25 books on bats, whereas their school library probably doesn't have that as a resource.
We hear a lot about how kids today have abandoned books for video games and the internet. But there are still more than enough young readers to fill these bookmobiles.
They're very imaginative. They have these great ideas for stories after they've read books, and they have great ideas to write about. And they are just really enthusiastic about learning and love school at this age, which is a lot of fun for me.
And when you get into a book, it feels like you're like nowhere. You're just into the book a lot. And it's really cool.
Because sometimes if you read and you like the book a lot, you can feel like you're a character in the book and your imagination. And then, like, really good books can just take you places that you've never been before.
Well, a lot of times they think that we're a family group and that the driver, who is usually a man, is the father. And there's usually an older woman, and she obviously is the mother. And the younger woman is usually the child. And they think that we're volunteers, and they think we actually live on the bookmobile. And they think we're so lucky because we get to read all these books all the time.
It's like being a gypsy. I go in, I have fun, and I leave before they get tired of me. So it's really a very nice job. Best job I've ever had.
The very first bookmobiles began 100 years ago on wagons. So it's not surprising that for kids and bookmobilers alike, there's a mystique about these little libraries on wheels. In fact, there's a whole body of children's literature about bookmobiles.
We're introducing them to lifelong reading. We're introducing them to their first library card. And we want to instill those habits so that when they're older and their parents themselves, that they think about bringing their children to the library.
Everything we human beings know, or think we know, is in books. But it could all be lost in a single generation if no one read them. So next time you see a bookmobile, smile. Someone's going to get a book today.
If it's a Sunday and you have nothing to do, just read, and like, it's so much funner than just going to play outside because it's such a cool adventure. It's really cool.
Well, I saw quite a crying, but I'm out on the road again. I'm on the road again. Well, I'm so tired of crying, but I'm out on the road again. I'm on the road again.